It says you're the scientist here on the NASA website.
Yeah, I'm involved in the project, but...
You are a scientist, so then, and you know that this is experimental, you've never done it before?
No, it's been done in the 1970s, it's been done recently in the 1990s and 2000. It hasn't been done since 1970, the lithium release in the daytime.
Why would it be done now then, sir? That's scary.
Detailed information, if you could please send your comments by email.
Okay, will you respond to my email if I send them?
Happy to answer them, yes. We're very interested in making sure everyone knows what we're doing. We're not, we're a civilian space agency dedicated to science and research and so on. So we're very, very keen to make sure that the taxpayers know what we're doing and everything. Right. There was lithium dispersed, and I'll be happy to talk to you about it. I think you might be under some misconceptions about what we're doing, but I'm happy to tell you any details that you need.
Well, I know that it says in your article that you're doing it for communications.
Okay, I'm happy to talk to you more about it. There are many reasons we're doing it.
Okay.
We don't understand how the wind in the upper atmosphere moves.
Mm-hmm.
In these chemtrails, there's different kinds of chemtrails, as you probably know. Different trails at night we use and different trails during the day. The wind blows them around. They glow either on their own or from scattered sunlight. We take pictures and we can see how the wind trail moves around and use that to infer what the wind is. Just like if you were taking a picture of an airplane contrail. You can use that to see how the wind was blowing up at those altitudes. This is much higher altitude, so we use these chemical trails.
And what is the purpose of knowing what the wind's going to do in the ionosphere?
The purpose is the ionosphere is really to understand our planet. It's very fundamental science. We're trying to understand every day we know there's electric currents that flow over the head. They're just naturally there. They've been there for, you know, ever since the Earth had an atmosphere and a magnetic field. And the wind is driven by the sun. The sun heats the atmosphere. The wind blows. And every day that wind drives an electric current, and we're trying to understand what causes that, essentially how does it work in detail. And also importantly, when the sun becomes active with lots of sunspots and lots of magnetic activity, that changes the wind pattern and changes the electric current. So we want to understand both what it is on a regular day when there's no solar activity, and then what it is when there's a lot of solar activity. We're researching other ways. The lithium is actually harmless to the environment, and we could show you more about that, but it is tricky to use because we have to, it's very faint. You can't see it with your naked eye. You have to, you know, have special cameras to see it and so on. So we don't like to use it for that reason. It's hard, in other words, it's hard measurement to make. We're researching other ways to put sensors directly on the rocket to measure the wind, and those are ongoing. We're trying to develop those now. In fact, one of the purposes of this mission was to do that.
Okay. Well, you've explained it to me then. I don't agree with it, but I appreciate you explaining it to me.
Mel, too, if you have detailed questions, anything you want.
Okay, I will. I'm gonna research it a little more, and I will email you, and I appreciate you taking the time out to speak to me today, sir.
Your call. It's not often we get to hear from members of the public, and people are really interested and concerned with what we're doing.
I
really appreciate your time.
I wish more people would call. I really do.